Cell and gene therapies are emerging technologies to help alleviate patients who are suffering from a genetic abnormality. And as a reminder, our genetic material moves from DNA to then RNA, and then RNA to protein. So if someone is having a genetic abnormality at the DNA level, this is ultimately going to affect the amount of protein that's being made. And this can result in either too much of a certain type of protein being made, or too little of a certain amount of protein being made. And both of these can have consequences on how the cell functions, since proteins are needed for every single role. Now, the goal of gene therapy is to improve that gene's function. Now, one way that has been approved is through CAR T-cell therapy. And specifically, this has been used for oncology treatments, but it is in development for other types of conditions as well. And the way that it works is that our immune cells, or specifically T-cells, have been isolated out. Then they're engineered to hold certain type of receptors. And these receptors are specific to the type of cancer that the patient has. Then they're delivered back to the patient so that that way those immune cells can go and attack the cancer, hoping to alleviate that individual's symptoms. However, there are a variety of other different types of gene therapy that are in clinical and preclinical development. One of these include CRISPR, which is a way to actually provide genetic information as well as proteins that can go in and cut out the inherent genetic mutation and then paste in that repaired amount of DNA that has been added. Additionally, there's viral delivery, such as using a virus that can integrate its genome into the patient. One of these is known as a lentivirus. So if that lentivirus DNA can be engineered to hold on to that improved gene function, be delivered to a patient, it can then resolve the inherent genetic mutation that the patient has. Now, both of these are currently being evaluated for acute and chronic conditions to help alleviate a variety of different diseases that people face.